Hello everyone. Today we'll discuss the unit 4 and first topic from unit 4 that is related with hemicoil data. And first topic is the general characteristics in phylum hemicoil data. These are the four topics in the unit 4. This is the diagram showing the hemichordate or the typical hemichordate, that we called it as a balanoglossus. What are the general characteristics of hemichordate? These hemichordates are exclusively marine. Exclusively marine means they all are the marine form living in the seawater. They may be solitary or colonial, or means they remain solitaries or singly or remain in a group, that we called it as a colonial. And these are soft bodied animals, and body is what, the worm like rounded, and mostly they are tubiculous animals. What is the tubiculous? Tubiculous means tube dwelling. This is the what, they are living in the tube like structure made up of the sand, and that we called it as a what, the tubiculous. Then the body of these hemichordates is divided into three regions. If you observe this, the uppermost part or the first part, that is a proboscis, middle part, that we called it as a collar, and the tail part, or that we called it as a trunk region. So in these hemichordates, the body is divided into three parts, that is proboscis, then collar, and the trunk. Then these animals are the soft bodied, vermiform or worm like triploblastic, and body is bilaterally symmetrical. You can cut it into two equal halves, and body is without segmentation, or it is not segmented. Then the body wall of this hemichordate is a single layered epidermis, means body wall of this animal, it having only epidermis, and below the epidermis there is a dermis present in the mammals, but in these hemichordates the lower layer dermis is absent. Then the next characteristics of hemichordate is a body cavity or the true coelom is present in this animal, and the coelom, it is present in all three body parts, that is the what, this proboscis, then collar, and the what, the collar and the trunk region. But it is not present in the adult animal, it is present in the what, that is the embryonic stage. So the body or cavity, it comprises of the true coelom, and the coelom having the three parts. The coelom which is present in the proboscis, that is called as a protocoel. The coelom which is present in the collar region is called as mesocoel, and the coelom which is present in the trunk part, that we called it as a metacoel. Then hemichordate, the meaning is the what, the half chordates. Hemi means few chordate characters are there with these animals, and therefore these are called as hemichordates. One of the important character which this possesses, that is the what, a buccal diverticulum, that is a rod like structure, hard structure, which arises from the roof of the buccal cavity. Means from the roof of the buccal cavity there arises a what, the buccal diverticulum, which projects into the proboscis coelom, and it was earlier regarded as a what, notochord, but it is not a true notochord. It is not a true notochord. It is a buccal diverticulum. There are many paired permanent gill slits. These are the gills which are present. These are the gill pores. This is a branchial region. Here the word gills are there. There are the many paired gill slits and complete digestive tract with a terminal anus. Means digestive tract starts from the mouth and ends at the anus, or U-shaped with a anus and anus nearer to mouth. As it is a tubiculus, that is what, if this is a mouth and this is an anus, if this both, if this is at this end, and if this tail is at this end, this anus and the mouth, they are lying side by side. So this can be said as a word, that is the anus nearer to the mouth when they are in the tube. Then these organisms feed on the microorganisms, or these hemichordates is feeds on the microorganisms and debris by the ciliary mechanism or with the help of the cilia. Then nervous system, it is present, and it is a primitive type of nervous system, and it comprises of intraepidermal nerve plexuses. Then circulatory system, in this hemichordate, that is a closed type of the circulatory system. There is no open type, it is a closed type, means advanced type of the circulatory system. Then in this hemichordate, the blood is colorless and without any blood cells. So blood cells are absent in the blood, and how it is a colorless. Then the excretory organ in these hemichordates is a single glomerulus situated in the proboscis region. Means excretory organ, it is confined to which region? It is confined to the proboscis region, and it is in the form of the single glomerulus. Then reproduction in this hemichordate is a sexual type of the reproduction. Sexes are separated, or sometimes these animals may be hermaphrodite, that the both the sexes are present in a single animal. And gonads, there may be one or many pairs. In these balanoglossus, this is a branchiogenital region. Branchial means what? That is a gills, and genital means the what? The reproductive organs. Here the what? That is the reproductive organs are there, and therefore this region is called as a what? Branchiogenital region. So the reproduction is sexual, and the what? The sexes are separated, or hermaphrodites, and gonads one or many pairs. As they are aquatic, the fertilization in this animal is the what? External. Means external fertilization is there, and the development may occur directly. That means egg may hatch into the direct animal, or indirectly that egg hatches, or egg give rise to the what? That is the larva, and that larva, or typical larva of this hemichordate, is the Tornaria larva. And there are about 70 species of these hemichordata. Example are the Balanoglossus, Cephalodiscus, and Sacoglossus. Only 70 species are there, and therefore these animal, or these hemichordata phylum, it is only divided into the what? That is a one group, and that is called as a what? The Enteropneusta. Means that phylum hemichordata having the only class, that is the Enteropneusta, and this Enteropneusta is not again divided into the orders. Means these Balanoglossus, or the phylum Balanoglossus, it is limited to only one class, and that is all the animals, or the all these 70 species belongs to the only one class, and that class is the Enteropneusta. No further division or classification of these class is done, because they resembles with the each other. So these are the what, the characteristic features of this, the what hemichordate, or the general characteristics of the what? Phylum Hemichordata. Thank you.